Hi there, and welcome. My name is John Crowe. Welcome to Pro Chef Academy. So today I hope you really enjoyed the video that I've made for you. It's another technique, another skill that I'd like you to master. Please join me on the journey and we can grow together, grow this community. Like I said, place a comment, hit that subscribe button, share the content, and we'll see you very soon. Enjoy the video. Welcome to Pro Chef Academy. So today here we're going to larder or prepare a whole plaice. We're going to do four cuts from this plaice. And as you can see here, I have a beautiful fresh plaice. We know the quality points, nice bright eyes, nice sea slime, nice fresh sea smell from the fish. No blemishes, no rips, no tears. And now we're going to go on and we're going to prepare it. First I want to do is I just want to take off the sides here. Okay, just like so. So if you just prick them up like that and we go from tail to head, they are easier to cut off. And I have a fish scissors here. Like so. We'll just place that to one side. This is a beautiful fresh fish. It's just come in literally 5 minutes ago. It's always better to buy your fish fresh on the day and try not to buy fish on a Monday if you can. Okay, with that removed there, you could remove this if you wanted to as well. And then turn over the other side. Like so. So as we said, this is a flatfish. And when we're storing this, we want to store this between 0 and 1. We also have 2 eyes here, which we would like to remove. So we just cut around them. It's easier than with a knife. We want to try and get them out unbroken, if possible. Again, then, just when we're going to prepare stocks and stuff like that, it is better if we can remove the eyes so they don't taint the stock or make it cloudy. Okay, so just in like that and just remove any tissue there that is holding it here, like so. Okay, so just always remember that the meat goes up along here, so we want to ensure there that when we're going around the head of the fish there, that we go up around there. You could also, if you wanted to, just insert the knife there and then just cut around it, and then you're sure then up by the side of the fish, so we get that beautiful direction and flow of the fish. You can see here then there's a natural line down along the fish that separates the fillet, and will also show you where you need to cut. So we put the point of knife right up by the head and we start to cut down. So as you can see here, we're starting to cut, and we just follow this natural line down, cut right down to the bone is really important. We run our hand in, our fingers in there, and we can push the fillet out to one side like that. That will allow us access with our knife then, and we can put our knife in and we can start to remove the flesh. We have a flexible blade on our fish knife, and that is why we use it, and that's the knife we want to use. And we cut in and we follow the contour of the bone. And in and slice, in and slice. And just follow that bone up along, like so, right up to the head. Like I said, we've pre-cut there as well. That'll make our fillet easier to remove. And there we have one fillet removed. That's the first fillet. Now we want access to the second fillet, okay? So we have a backbone there, and we just want to get at the far side of that ridge. So if we put our knife in and then just go along like that at the far side of the ridge, as you can see, I'll push it back with my finger, and we are going to get access to that second fillet. Always remember that these fillets on this side of the fish will be larger than the fillets underneath. As well then, remember that the fillet is only going to come up to around here, and then we also have the roll and everything else inside.
We're now going to remove the second filler. So again, we use my fingers just to push it back. We insert the knife and in there with the knife.
And we use the contour again, like I said, of the skeletal of the fish to help us remove our fillet. So there we have our second fillet off, and we have a little bit of roe here as well, like so. You can see here we have the roe here, and we're just going to remove that as well. And that can generally just be pulled off. Like so. And then we'll just present that on the side, and we'll present it at the moment. There's our second fillet off. We're going to trim it up in a moment, but we'll just place it to one side. So we've just turned our fish over. It's always important then, as you go along and you're
preparing fish that you keep your area, your board and your area clean at all times, and then we dispose of this in your waste bowl. We have the second side here. Again, then you see the fillet does go up along the side here. So we just want to cut up there. It just makes it easier again when we're removing the fillet. Again, we're going to follow this line down along here. That's going to give us access to our fillets. So like so here, we just follow this line, getting right down to the bone, like so. And then we put our finger in just to help us remove the fillet. So again, flexible blade, we insert the blade and off like that. And we follow the natural contour of this flat fish up along there like that. And just cut, and then like I said, another fillet off, lovely. And we put that to one side. And this fillet, and turn the item around so you feel comfortable working with it. Again, like I said, these fillets are generally smaller, okay? And then you just run it up just so you get over the hump of the backbone there. And then we turn it over, and now we are going to remove that fillet. Again, then just follow the contour of the fish. Like so. And we cut that off. And then again, then we have the roe here, which you just need to remove. And that will generally just be able to pull off. Like so, and we'll just place this on our tray to one side. There's our second fillet, which we will trim up in a second. Now, if you have any flesh left, okay, so I have a little bit of flesh here, as you can see here. What I would generally do then is I would scrape this. So if you have any flesh left, you could use a teaspoon and you could scrape your bones there. Just to make sure there that your bones are nice and clean. This can also be presented in a little dish on the side. Again, it just makes your bones look nice and clean. Again, I have a little tiny bit of flesh left at this side. So it would be better to take this flesh off and present it on the side. Then you're showing skill that you know it could be processed on for mousse or whatever, and that you want to present your bones nice and clean as opposed to leaving the flesh on like so. There's only a tiny little bit, but better just to show. When we turn the other side there, again we'll just scrape these here, but this is good, this side here, like that. Generally you will have half an hour for this task, so it's more than enough. And the excess skin there, you just cut that off. So what we need to do now is we need access to the inside here. As you can see, there's some blood and some bits of innards here that we need to remove. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this to the sink and we're going to wash it out. What we also don't want to forget is we don't want to forget to remove this, which is really important. And it's just a matter of cutting it in like that, both sides of the fish, to free it, like so. So you get just the fish scissors, there we go. And we remove the gills like that. Okay, they can also be presented. So it's really important there that we don't forget to remove the gills. Okay, so we have transported our fish to the sink. Okay, I would also transport it on a tray when you're bringing it over to the sink. It just means you're not dripping. It's cleaner and tidier looking. What we need to do then is we need to remove the blood that's on the inside and any innards as well. It might be an idea also to bring a spoon and also possibly a fish scissors here in case there's any items that need to be cut on the inside. So here then on the inside here, we're now going to wash. Okay, so we have a couple of items here that we need to remove. Okay, anything like that there can be removed. Like I said, you may need a scissors to cut that out, so bring it with you. And a spoon is also a good item then as well that will help you, because you can see there we have the blood there that we want to remove. So if we want to scrape that, and you can see there the blood is coming out, we want to wash that out.
and we want to clean off the skeleton of our fish. We give it a good clean on the inside as well, and remove if there's any blood there, anything like that there. It can be removed or it needs to be washed, like so. This is a fairly clean fish, nice and neat and clean on the inside. Wash it out thoroughly. Okay, so as you can see here, the inside is now clean. This here is not coming off, so it's just in the actual bone itself. And then we put it back, washer spoon. Another point there as well is to leave your sink clean. You can wash out your sink and leave it clean here before you leave your the sink area. We have it on a tray for transporting again. It's nice and neat and clean and tidy, and we're ready to go back to our bench. Okay, so we've come back from the sink area where we washed our fish out. You can dry it over there at the sink area if you want, or you come back to your board. We've wiped down the board as well. We have our paper toweling, which is good to have your paper toweling beside you. And we just dry off our fish, make sure it's bone dry, okay, and the inside of it. And then obviously I have my waste bowl here to one side, so that nothing, my area is kept clean and tidy. Dispose of your blue paper into your waste bowl, and all we have to do there now is we just have to cut your fish 2 to 3 times down along the back. Okay, and we bend it like that. And that will allow there, generally what you would do to make fish stock with this, you would soak this in cold running water for a number of hours so all that blood can leach out so it doesn't taint your stock. Okay, and we just put that back there like that. Okay, what we need to do then is we need to just bring back our fillets there that we just need to process. Just give it a wipe again. Okay, so we have a number of cuts to do or to present from this. So the first thing we need to do is we need to skin our fish. So just catch, you can tab, and with this hand I slightly pull, and with my right hand the knife, I glide the knife with a slight angle up along underneath on the skin, like so. And then what we do is we just check the skin there, okay? And at this point, as you go along, what I would also do is just flatten it out there like that. And then I would just fold it, and it's just nicer for presentation. I'll just pop that to one side. The fillet then, we have some little side skirt here. I generally would take that off. Some people say it's lovely and sweet, but I think it takes then just from the perfect shape of our fillet, and it will either pull off there like that. And we just keep that, and it's only going with the flesh that we scraped from the bone. So our fillet then, all we need to do is turn it over here. And with this one here, we're just going to make a delice. So what I'm going to do, delice, some people would score it like so, okay, and some people would just put a little nick in it there. It just helps the fold. So the delice there is a neatly trimmed and folded fillet of fish. So we'll just pop that to one side. Okay, the next one we want to do then is the other long fillet. Okay, we just need to skin this again. So hold your tab, cut your skin like so, and then we just want to keep filleting our fish like that. Again, there I have my skin, so I just want to fold that skin nice and neat, so just for presentation, like so. And we just pop that to one side. Again, then our fillet here, just this side skirt. Like I said, a lot of time it will just pull off. You need to cut it, you can. There. And we have another beautiful fillet of neatly trimmed fish. And with this one here then, we are just gonna leave it like that. Now if you had little touches of blood there, there's nothing you can do. If you can cut them off, beautiful, okay. Just a little bit of bruising in the fish. And we'll just pop that to one side again. The next fillet then, just one of the smaller fillets. Again, we want to skin. And this one here is going to be our paupiette. Okay, so if you have extra flesh there, just cut that off. And that can go into our trimmers, like so. Again, just check it here. That can be just cut there. And again, then we are just going to fold this, like so. We'll pop that to one side. And then this will need a little bit of extra trimming, because we just have a little bit where the roll was, so that will just need to be trimmed. And we want to keep the contour of the fish when you are trimming. You want to keep a natural looking shape to your fillet. Okay? and then we just turn it over. And then with this here, we're just going to do our paupiette. So it's just a matter of rolling the fillet there like so. Okay, and that could also be stuffed, and that's your paupiette.
And our final fillet here, we're just going to skin it like so. Slight angle, like I said, left hand here, I'm just pulling slightly, and the right hand with my knife, I'm just moving up gently, like so. Just check your skin, all the flesh is removed from the skin, and again, we just want to neatly fold that, just for presentation, as part of our display at the end. Fold that in, it's kind of neat looking. Pop that over there, and then this here, like I said, some of the side flesh, this can go with your trimmings that we had earlier. Be held, and this here then is just going to be trimmed off. Tweeze. A little tiny bit of black there. Again, like I said, we want to keep a natural shape to the fillet. And with this one here, we're going to cut some goujons. Okay. So these, for this here, you're going to need a ruler. And generally, the rule is for goujons there, we need a ruler for this, which you will have. So it's 8 centimeters by a half centimeter. Okay, so that is generally the thickness of your fillet, the length and the thickness there, okay? So we have 8 centimeters, and then we want to get the half centimeter thickness. So with this ruler, it's just good here, we'll measure, okay? And we'll cut the first one like that. I find it's easier there if we cut them at a slight angle. Any trimmings like that can go with your trimmings. And we look to cut the second one here. Okay. And again here, we're looking for the length here. Okay. Cutting these to one side. And we want to get the natural length of the fillet. Okay, like so. Pop them to one side, and then we can sort them out. And the last one here, so we're going to get, and then this bit here, I wouldn't waste, I would just add that to my trimmings. So you don't have any waste. And then if we just get those, generally what I would do is I would give them a little roll, like so. And then we're just lining these all up. Okay, because you may need just to trim these slightly, like so. But we lay them all out first, and then we can see if there's any issues. Okay, so lay them as straight and neat as you can, and we just double check then and see if they need any trimming. Okay, so I would just trim if required. Again, this just shows skill here and attention to detail. We keep all those trimmings. Second one here. Let's trim this as well. The next one here. Like so. Next one. They're not going to need very much, but I think they're just, it just shows their like so. And the last one there. It's ever so slightly. Okay. We have a ruler. These can be kept. So now we were just left with just presenting our end products. So here I have my presentation tray, and now I'm going to present my plaice. So I'm just going to start here. Okay, and all these have been dried as well. Okay. Like so. Here we have our rose. Here like that. We have our two eyes here, which we're going to present like so. We have our four skins, which we just do along the edge here. Like so. And it's just about presenting the skills that you have. A little bit of things there, just pop them there. I also have all my trimmings and scrapings. And I'm just going to pop them
for the moment there, bringing them up. I'm just gonna put them there. And then we start then with our fillets. So I have my fillet, I have my Delice, I have my Paupiette, and I have my Goujons, 8 centimeter by 0.5 centimeter, like that. Okay, it's just about showcasing the skill that you have. And finally then, we have our fish here, our plaice, we'll just pop that like that. Okay, just try not to cut through the bone like I did. And there we have our finished product. So then we just clean away our area like so. So here we have the finished item here, as you can see. We have a whole plaice which we've lardered. We have our goujons, 8 centimeter by 0.5 centimeter. We have our Delice, neatly trimmed and folded. We have our Paupiette, neatly trimmed and rolled. Our 4 skins, our 2 eyes, our fins, our trimmings, 2 side skirts, our roe, and then the whole boned carcass of the fish that's left. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, subscribe and share to the channel, and we'll speak to you very soon again. Thank you.